Good morning, everybody. Another episode of Nate G219 to Hell But Back and Better. Another one coming at you this morning. It's an early one, 4 a.m. on Monday. Gotta go to work today. So, I'm always trying to be productive. And if I gotta make a video in the morning, I gotta make a video in the morning. That's what I gotta do. So, this one, another one from Indiana State Prison coming at you. This is going to be about another sick individual I had met. Not as sick as Tex. Well, I can't say that. He's a pretty sick individual. But not quite as mentally ill as Tex. He's got to be mentally ill, though. For his crimes, the crimes that he committed, no person that is sane could ever do it. This man had spent 6 years in prison. At this point in time, I did not know what it was for. So I'm not going to tell you until the end, because you need to find out how I felt, found out. This man comes into the prison one day, 400 range. This is the summer of 2015, so it's probably June, maybe, I'm going to guess. Comes walking down the range. You can tell he's a little goofy, but, you know, who cares? We're in prison. And our only concern is, did he touch a child? Or did he hurt a woman? Mainly, did he hurt a child or touch a child? And we ask him what he's there for. He says, robbery, homicide. He says the robbery was over a Subway sandwich. No, it sounds ridiculous, but it's an acceptable crime. In my environment at that time, it's an acceptable crime. He had even went as far to produce paperwork to show me, see, robbery, homicide. I could see there's a robbery, there's a homicide, it's over a Subway sandwich, yada, yada, yada. But because of his willingness to give me his paperwork, I didn't look through like I was a lawyer or anything. This man seemed to be pretty honest with me. And the fact that he'd killed somebody over a Subway sandwich, I mean, it'd be a pretty crazy lie, especially when you're convicted of it and sentenced to 111 years. Well. The 111 years was a plea agreement. They were trying to give him the death penalty, he said. So he took the 111 years with a smile. He's got to serve 85% of that. The man will never come home, thank God, because, man, what I found out. But while inside, Jason and I'd called him Lee, we'd be smoking cigarettes. I made some food. Hey, Lee, you hungry? Here's a bowl of food, Lee. You know, extra sheets, whatever. Looking out for a guy that didn't have any money coming in. I was going home in a couple months. Well, this man did have a hustle. This man's hustle was making picture frames out of playing cards or potato chip wrappers, the aluminum silver inside. She makes a pretty cool looking picture frame. If I find one, I gotta pull it out and show you guys one day. They can make them out of playing cards. Most creative people and smartest people I've ever met are in prison. Most people would never even consider the possibility that things can be done the way that they're done. Simply as boiling water with a cord hanging out of the wall, or lighting a cigarette with a pencil and a wire that's plugged into a plug. It's other stories to come along. And if you guys help me grow, those stories will be coming. But again to Lee. Lee's walking around making friends with everybody, and for the most part. And Lee didn't stay to himself like you would think what I'd tell you was. He didn't fit the ideal sex offender status look. And well. Lee was a sick man, to say the least. When I came home, out of curiosity, I started Google searching certain people. People I would hang out with. Just, I would like to know who I was around, what they really did, who was lying, who wasn't lying. Most of them were lying. Very few weren't. Lee was lying. Well, he lied about half of his situation. First, he had said his previous prison sentence was for stealing. I don't remember, maybe a burglary. I don't remember what he said. It's not what it was for. When I researched it, it was child molestation. Then, the 111 years, Lee, yes, he was convicted of robbery, homicide, as well as the rape that nobody ever mentioned. And that was unfortunate. So the story was, gentleman that was letting Lee live with him because Lee had no place to go, came home from work or whatnot. This is in Greene County, Indiana, a lot of farmland down there, middle of nowhere. He comes home with Subway for him and his wife. Lee's pissed off because Lee's hungry. Lee's been up for a couple days on meth, whatever else had been going on. That was a big part of it, was the meth. Lee proceeded to get pissed off. They had an argument back and forth. Lee grabbed a 30-06, boom, through the driver's window, shoots the man in the face. That's the end of him. Lee proceeds to go into the house, tying up the wife. Lee had her tied up for 3 days. At least that's what I've read. I'm not a journalist, so you guys can fact check whatever. If something's different, please tell me. I'll do an update video. But from what I've read, he had her tied up, violating her on and off, over and over, for 3 days. Lee took that plea agreement for 111 years because they were going to kill him if he didn't. It would have been better off for everybody if they'd have just put that man in death row, because I promise you this, that man's not having a hard time. That man's walking around prison happier than can be. I was going to say something, but it's not going to... I'd probably get my video removed if I had said what I was going to say. But Lee's a happy man. Yes, he'd be happier if he was home. He'd be happier if he was able to do whatever the hell he wanted to do outside. But that was molesting children. That was being the most sick individual you could ever be. Now, there's just nothing that can be done. Yeah, he's never going home. But the rest of his life, around who's become his friends now, I'm sure, because people like that find a group, stick with that group, stay with that group. And that group will fend for each other. It's a very weird group. You can usually see them off in the corner, out in the yard, huddled together and being all weird talking about whatever they're talking about, but you can usually tell. You just could not tell with Lee, or at least I couldn't at the time. I wish I had. Gosh, do I wish I had the ability to know what exactly what people did, but we just don't have that. But anyways, it's another video for you. Please like, subscribe, share. I'm gonna be doing some more videos for everybody. I'm gonna be doing a lot of different things, and I may have a little promotion help coming towards me, so the videos should start getting better. But thanks, like, subscribe. See you next time.